The Quran says, the first verse that comes forward and says, tell them, inform them about the story of the sons of Adam, which is truthful. It's not a myth. It's not fabricated. It is absolute fact. إِذْ قَرَّبَا قُرْبَانَا. They offered a sacrifice. Now this sacrifice is what? Qaabeel, according to the narrations, offered a sheep. The best sheep that he can have. He was a shepherd, so he offered the best sheep. Qaabeel was a farmer. He offered what? This ears of corn, which were dry, which were old, which were quite useless. So he presented them and he placed them on top of the mountain. And so did Qaabeel. The sheep was placed there. According to the riwayat, the ears of corn were destroyed by Allah, whereas the sheep was kept without any harm. And this was the indication that Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has accepted the offering of Qaabeel salamullahi alayhi. فَتُقُبِّلَ مِنْ أَحَدِهِمَا. Allah accepted from one of them, whilst he did not from the other. The moment this happened, Qabil's heart is filled with what? Animosity and hate. قَالَ لَأَقْتُلَنَّكَ. He says to his brother, Qabil, I'm going to kill you. You see, sometimes when things don't go our way, the only way we can think of is violence. That is the only solution we have in our minds. Anger, verbal abuse, for example, when things don't go our ways. This is the method of Shaitan. Qaabeel was overpowered by Shaitan, yes? And he said to his brother Qaabeel, the only way that I will feel better is if I kill you. What did Qaabeel reply? قَالَ إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Hold on a minute, Qaabeel says to him. Let me explain to you why Allah accepted what I offered and did not accept what you offered. Because there is the acceptance with regards to the prerequisite of the act, which is taqwa. لَئِنْ بَسَطْتَ إِلَيَّ يَدَكَ لِتَقْتُلَنِي. Next verse. If you are going to raise your hands to kill me, مَا أَنَا بِبَاسِطٍ إِلَيَّ وَمَا أَنَا بِبَاسِطٍ يَدِيَ إِلَيْكَ لِأَقْتُلَكَ. I am not going to raise my hands to kill you. إِنِّي أَخَافُ اللَّهَ رَبَّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Here, it is the position of Qaabeel to admonish his brother, to give words of advice, to calm him down, to say that even if you are here to kill me, I am going to have to defend myself, but in that process I will not kill you. And just because you have the intention to kill me, I will not preempt this by killing you. So you say, he had the intention of harming me, therefore I should harm him before he harms me. Quran, he says, no, until, that is why in the battlefields, in the battle of Siffin, in the battle of Karbala, the Ahlelbayt would say, we would not be the first to commence the battle. Let them shoot first. Let them commence first. Yes? Qaabeel says, I am afraid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is too much to lose. But unfortunately, what happened was that Shaytan spoke to Qaabeel and said to him, if you don't kill him, his sons and his offsprings will overpower yours. Because Allah has chosen him. He has become what? The successor of your father Adam. Therefore the only way to eliminate him and his progeny is by finishing him off. Is by killing him. فَطَوَّعَتْ لَهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, نَفْسُهُ قَتْلَ أَخِي. In verse 30, that his nafs became so overpowering to the extent that he decided to kill his brother. How did he do it? His brother was asleep. According to narrations, he came and he threw a rock on top of his brother Qaabeel and he killed him. فَقَتَلَهُ فَأَصْبَحَ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. He woke up, or he therefore became of those who were the losers. But he, Qaabeel, was in a dilemma. Because he had no idea how to dispose of the body. He had never seen anyone being killed. This is, according to narrations, the first record of a killing this earth has ever seen. Of a slaughter, yes, of homicide, of any human being this earth has witnessed. Therefore, he began to carry the body wherever he went, and he placed it on the ground. But there were animals, there were wild birds who would come on the body. And he was unaware of how to proceed until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as according to the next verse, فَبَعَثَ اللَّهُ غُرَابًا يَبْحَثُ فِي الْأَرْضِ. He, Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala, sent a crow that showed him by burying another bird. How to bury, لِيُرِيَهُ كَيْفَ يُوَارِي سَوْءَةَ أَخِيهِ, so that he shown how to bury the body of his brother. قَالَ يَا وَيْلَتَا أَعَجَزْتُ أَنْ أَكُونَ مِثْلَ هَذَا الْغُرَابِ. In verse 31, he, Qaabeel, look at this. He began to feel remorseful, not for the killing, not for the slaughtering of his brother, but because he was not aware how to bury the body of his brother. Quran is very specific. According to most of the Mufassireen, Qaabeel did not ask for forgiveness and tawbah. He did not somehow feel remorseful. Qaabeel felt a sense of what? He felt a sense of disappointment with himself, and he's not able to somehow figure out what to do with the body. He had to learn from a bird. And the bird showed him, فَأُوَارِيَ سَوْءَةَ أَخِي فَأَصْبَحَ مِنَ النَّادِمِينَ. He consequently became of the remorseful ones, regretful ones. Question, regretful of the death or no? Many of the ulama say, we don't know. But it's likely that he was not regretful over killing his brother, because the Quran would have said that he asked for repentance, that he asked for tawbah, whereas he did not. Yes? He became nadim, regretful, because of the fact that he somehow felt short in his understanding, that he was not able to dispose of the body in the most appropriate way.